you guys are ready to go, let's have some fun with it. We got Pro Dunk Bulky Booby Taser Saw. Let's go. Ultimately, our guys thought they played really hard, and we got rewarded for it. At the same time, once it's over, and on to the next one.
Marvelous performance from the team.
The Hawks will take a one-game-to-none lead.
The Oilers have responded. They have evened this series at a game apiece with a 6-3 win in Game 2.
I think in the playoffs, it's about not getting too high, not getting too low, so that's going to be our mindset.
It's a best of three within a best of five. This is it, Game 3, Edmonton, Chicago.
You know, there's no real home team here, but I've enjoyed it, just, you know, especially once we got into the first few days, just being able to go to the rink and watch games and having all the teams together and being able to walk everywhere. That's a huge thing. And also, we got a lot more time with the players. That's kind of neat, actually. It's reminds me of like a World Junior Tournament or World Championship. It's kind of a hockey festival. Pretty interesting to watch a playoff series, not just one, but all of them. Coaching without fans is certainly a different experience. I think it probably affects the players more than the coaches, just because I think they use the adrenaline to reach their top level. But I think everyone's done a good job of when the puck drops, it's been really competitive and we know what's on the line. We understand that we're a bit of an underdog here, but we're embracing it. First of all, we're excited to get the opportunity to play in a playoff series and we're trying to make the most of it. But this experience for all of us is going to help going forward. Of course, we want to be an elite team in the league, and to go through this process and test ourselves in a playoff series, we've got to enjoy the opportunity and make the most of it.
And the Hawks turn a 3-2 loss into a 4-3 victory that has pushed Edmonton to the brink.
I know as a player, I wanted to win very badly, and I wanted the coach to run the team to give us the best chance. Teams that win, you have a togetherness that you never lose. So I think as a player and as a coach now, you're always chasing that feeling that everyone's willing to put individual priorities aside for the team to have success. And the teams that do that, they're the ones who are gonna end up winning. You can also lay the groundwork for the next guy who's gonna come on the ice to make the difference. And if you do it for him, he'll do it for you. I think that's a pretty good way to look at life. And I think if, as a team, we really embrace that, and I think we have, certainly when we're at our best, we'll give ourselves a chance.